Good evening. I'm Victor Blackwell.
And I'm Tiffany Kenny. Thank you for joining us. DCF just released a phone call made to its anonymous abuse hotline. It details the abuse the Barahona twins allegedly suffered at the hands of their adopted parents.
As Alexis Rivera explains, that phone call was made 4 days before authorities found the 10-year-old boy covered in chemicals and his twin sister's body on the side of the highway. Alexis.
That's right, Victor. Just days before that gruesome discovery was made, a relative who had been threatened not to tell anyone decided to finally report the abuse she witnessed inside the house.
It's all part of a DCF investigation to figure out if the abuse and death of a 10-year-old girl could have been prevented. The girl was found dead, stuffed in the back of her adoptive father, George Barahona's pest control truck. Just days after a call came into the agency's abuse hotline, DCF has just released that call. The complaint was originally made by Barahona's granddaughter to her therapist. The therapist then reported it.
I saw her in therapy, an individual therapy session, mm-hmm. and she stated that the house of her grandma, which she goes to after school, that there are foster children in there, and some of the foster children are being abused. And she was scared, and said that the...
Being abused by who?
Being abused by the grandparents.
How are the other children being abused?
When they're being punished, they're being taped up, and with their arms and legs, and put in a bathtub. And they're in there all day and all night. And she undoes their arms when they eat.
DCF worker who was responsible for following up on this call is under investigation. She is on paid administrative leave until they are done investigating this. In the newsroom, Alexis Rivera, WPBF 25 News.
An independent review panel will continue its investigation into DCF's handling of this case. The three-member panel will meet again tomorrow morning in Miami. Now, the panel is trying to determine how such horrific allegations of abuse could have gone unnoticed. After the investigation, the group will recommend ways to improve DCF. The final recommendation is due March 11th.
Well, the adopted 10-year-old boy found covered in chemicals along the side of I-95. He could soon be out of the hospital. The boy's guardian ad litem visited him today in the hospital. We're told he's doing much better. He could be released by tomorrow. A judge recently called his recovery miraculous. You can always find the very latest information on this story on WPBF.com. Learn more about the DCF employee who was assigned to the case and her history of problems. We've also posted photos, videos, all of our previous stories. Just click the link on the homepage.